Hello and welcome back, dear friends. It's me, Ordo, and I'm back in my Pathfinder Kingmaker campaign. We are currently just running around and killing monsters and getting XP before finding the Stag Lord. We leave stuff in the what's the word in English? The chest, my god. In the chest that we don't need. We just take 6 rations with us and something to cook. I'm not sure, we can now cook pancakes, so we need probably butter, milk and eggs and probably flour. So I'll take this, but I leave back the meat and onions and stuff like that. And for the just keep this coffee because they worked just fine before last time. So we will change our parties sometimes, but at the moment let's keep them as they are. Miri and Dragonar really do a lot of damage. So let's go down. Let's see if there is something inside here. Like, nothing. Just these places, but we need them only when we form the kingdom. There is this old sycamore. Here we will have to go. But first, we just look around. I mean, it's the only place. Let's fight it because we didn't fight today, and in the old sycamore we will have to camp anyway because it's really big.
I move unseen.
You?
I am yours to command.
Okay, you can't. Let's...
Face me if you dare.
Charge it. Really? You didn't attack it. Let's kill the skeleton soldier. Why can't we just shoot him?
Bring
ah,
it.
Because of the rain. Of course. We don't see him. Yay. So, it's a level 2 undead. This is not too hard to fight, I believe. 9 hit points and most of it... Oh, he has just 1 hit point left. Okay. Let's just assume we will kill him.
Your death awaits.
Yeah, like now. Oh, there is something else. Valerie!
Onwards.
How about Skeleton Soldier? He's more or less the same. Okay, let's take a 5-foot step. Like here. Miri! kill it. Tear them apart! It's just a skeleton. Yeah, and she killed it. Okay. Let's take the stuff.
That's easy.
Let me just leave this region. To start my timer. Let's do it now. After this fight, but it was really let's try to find
I need to catch my breath.
Let's just Yay. Ooh. Slarty part fast suddenly awoke inside the house. Dogs were howling fiercely. Not far away, it smelled like burning. The wooden walls were steaming hot and smoke was reefing beneath. Well, I'm not in a house. It must be a dream. Out the window. Let's look outside. The instant she approached the window, the glass broke and an arrow hit her in the chest. Yeah, that's good. Falling, she glimpsed a dozen figures standing outside. Her eyes dimmed. Slartipast Fast's skin felt cool. She heard the murmur of the water and the soft lapping of wind. After opening her eyes, she saw a rocky river bottom and a bloated body tangled in green water weeds. The drowned man's empty gaze was fixed upon Slartipast Fast. The drowned man's mouth opened slowly, and the hoarse whisper said, "Shark, right river, Slardibar Fast." This moment, Slardibar Fast finally awoke, drenched in sweat. She told us what she'd seen in the dream. In the dream. Yeah, okay. Ah, yeah, okay. Should we do this first? Nah, this can. Let's end. Kimor. First of all, we find here the herbs for the mushrooms for Bokken. Second of all, here will also the quest with Tartuccio go on, I believe. As we lost his trail before.
My instincts dull when I'm tired.
Ooh.
Greetings.
Kesten Garess, the former captain of Jamandi Eldori's personal guards, nods to you, as though you'd seen each other in rest of only yesterday. Well, yeah. He limps noticeably, and his clothes are stained with blood, and looks every bit as grim and focused as when you first met. But this time, you also sense a hint of excitement in his eyes.
I have urgent news from Restoff. The investigation that I have conducted at Lady Jamandi's orders have proved your innocence. Tartuccio was and still is the Pataxian spy. That dreadful night, it was him who had opened the gate and let the assassins in. It appears that he had planned to gain the barony and Eldori's support, only to later place these lands under the command of his true patron. King Iroveti is no stranger to intrigue and likes to use others to do his dirty work.
Yeah.
Anyway, Lady Jamandi sends her apologies.
Yeah. Nice, if she finds out.
They ordered me to capture Tartuccio. We were following his trail when that damned mist fell. First we entirely lost our way and then stumbled right into a bandit ambush. Alas, nearly all my people were wounded and can go no further. And so I am here asking for your aid. I'll point out on the map where Tartuccio is supposed to be. Bring that scum to Oleg's trading post, dead or alive. Restov will not forget this favor.
Yeah, whatever. Pine patch has been revealed. Okay. How did Tartuccio manage to fool
that
you?
That sly bastard has caused us no little trouble, that's for sure. When he showed up in Restov and announced he was going to join the expedition, nobody suspected a thing. Yes, a gnome. Yes, a sorcerer. But so what? Even after that terrible night, some of my people were willing to bet money on you being the spy.
Yeah, of course. It's always the elf.
His overconfidence was his downfall. Tartuccio's henchmen, it seems, imagined they could safely meet with Pataxian spies in the town's seedy underbelly. But Restov is the ancestral home of the Eldori, and Lady Jamondi is respected not only by the aristocracy and the common folk, but also by those on the other side of the law. We received a message from
there, another side of the law.
Friend, who wished to remain anonymous, suggested the sword lords take a closer look at a certain guest from Patax. Jamondi immediately sent for me and ordered me to capture the spy, all very quietly, of course. He told us everything, and not only about Tartuccio. I doubt that Iravetti was pleased to hear of his agent's failure.
Mm-hmm.
Pataxian spies are much like magpies. They'll grab anything that catches their eye. Information, treasure, artifacts. This time, King Iravetti had a chance to seize the entire stolen lands region, and at the Eldori's expense. I'll give you some advice for the future. Be wary of the Pataxian king. He's truly a snake of a man.
Yeah, of course. Let's ask him.
It's only a name now, nothing more. The House Garess are a noble family in Brevoy. They own several mines in the Galushkin Mountains. My father Evan is cousin to Lord Howland Garess, but he's my father no longer.
Yeah, because you have estranged family life. Okay, too much information. I really don't care.
My name and was punished accordingly.
Care to tell me why you were exiled?
Fair enough. For a Garess, the prosperity of the house and the honor of the name stands above all else. And I was betrothed to a widow from another noble house. This union was of great importance to the family. However, 3 months before the wedding, I met a commoner girl, gentle and pure, and we fell in love. I would have rather died than leave my Tanya. So I decided to break off the engagement with my noble bride. I could never have expected what would follow.
She betrayed you.
My father was furious. I'd set a pointless love affair above the interests of the house. He expelled me from the family and ordered to leave our lands under threat of death. And Tanya, her mother was seriously ill, and she stayed behind to care for her rather than follow me into exile.
Yeah.
Thus, I was on my own, disgraced, without a name, and without love.
Yeah, of course.
Don't imagine that I ask for pity. Everyone gets what they deserve.
Yeah. Lawful neutral, I hope you regret the things you've done. You should stand above
fairness
emotion.
Fairness befits a ruler. Be sure, I've learned my lesson well.
I would know more of House Garess and your
homeland. Well then, ask away.
Yeah.
House Garess owns a number of valleys and gorges in the Galushkin Mountains. The landscape makes these places easily defensible.
Do we really need to know
this? They're rich in ores and everything else the depths of the earth have to offer. It is a place of rare beauty. When I moved to Restov, I couldn't get used to it for a long time. There was nothing but sky between the roofs. No mountain peaks anywhere in sight.
There is so much flavor text, you don't know what is important and what is not.
It is an old and renowned family, one of the most influential in Brevoy.
Yeah, yeah.
A long
whatever.
Time ago, the Garess House entered a pact with the Dwarven clan of Golka. This proved to be of great benefit to both parties, and they've supplied the ore for our forges ever since. Lord Howland even took the son of the Dwarven leader as his ward. Who would have known where this would lead? The same winter that Brevoy lost the Garvia dynasty, Howland's only natural son, Bren, went missing in the mountains. Thus, Tovall Golka, the Lord's Dwarven ward, became heir to House Garess. The lad has it tough, though. Too many believed Howland should have chosen someone of his own blood to be the heir. I would imagine my own father had similar plans for me, but we all know how that went. As you wish.
Yeah, I'll see you later. Okay. Yeah. Let's just move around a bit. Although, rains here and it's really... Ugh, I hate it. Did we kill the elk? I really don't know. Clear. I know this is a really large map because we have to come here a lot of times.
Quiet footsteps.
And we should
an ambush,
do this. Ooh.
Time for fun.
Ooh. Oh, I should have known. Okay, Regongar. Let's just kill this giant. Well, we really killed the frog. Nice.
I'll loot your corpse. Kiss your life goodbye.
This was easy.
Stab their backs.
Wait, what? They didn't have anything to loot. What's that? Silver buckle. Okay, earrings. Let's take everything.
What's that thing?
I don't know. Just look at it.
Done and done.
Oh. Yeah, now I know why we need Lindsay, because she's the best in trickery. Okay, what do we have here? Mage armor. Potion, what's that? Hematite. Okay, well, take everything.
Careful now.
There's no way in this direction. Interesting. I'm not sure if the map probably changed since the last time
Precisely.
I played this game. Ah, yes. Battery.
I am your shield.
Can you just...
They should have known better.
Kill this to the kind. No, Octavio, don't go there. And me as well, of course. Tristan, just go there. Miri, she killed this thing. Yay, attack Valerie, that's good. Because you can't hit her. Not really, at least.
Bleed for me.
Okay. And another thing gone. Yes, probably we can. Ooh. No, go away. Don't kill Amiri. Yay, try to kill Valerie. That's great.
Cover me.
And another dead animal. So we really don't need the bless, I believe.
So it's come to this.
Stay behind me. They go down.
Yes, of course. Okay. Can we skin them? Really, only one succeeded. No, two succeeded. Okay. At least a bit of
quiet footsteps.
I'm not sure if I remember correctly, but there is some nice treasure in the left lower corner or something. And we can grow. Can climb up, but we probably don't do this now. Let's just run around. Stop!
Give them what they deserve.
Too fast. Too fast, my dear. Okay, let's do this. It's a level 3 dragon.
Yes.
How many hit points do they have? Like 30, 23, so it should be dead now.
Your death awaits.
Yep. Probably should have shot even on this one.
Bring it!
Nice. Didn't hit. Okay. Just 23 hit points, so we normally should kill it using any more magic. Like now. Ooh, a lot of stuff. Good. What's that? A crumpled letter. Let's take this. The rest let's take when we leave the camp. Okay. Super. Ooh, there's a campfire. I don't think that in the old game it looked like
what
that.
Is this?
Ooh, more stuff. What's the map? Ooh.
We will prevail.
Yeah. More frogs, yay. Let's do it. Hey. Okay.
Consider me provoked.
So how much do you just 50
I'll loot
points?
Your
normally
corpse.
It should be dead. Yeah. Right. Miri. Just do this, do this, and run here. Really? This is a greater giant frog. A giant frog and a greater giant frog. Great.
Let us strike as one.
Good. Okay, my friend. No, not a shield of faith. Let's do some healing on Amiri. Oh, it's a cure moderate wounds even.
For me,
of course.
This is for you.
You missed.
Stab their backs.
You missed as well.
Tear them apart.
They don't have any loot. Oh no. Yeah. Ah, yes. I can remember. You can climb up there. You'll have to stay safe there. Okay, my dear friend. I will stop for today. Next time, we will be upside. Because I will now save and try as long as it takes to get up. Till then, see you. Bye.